So I came across a problem the other day. My game, like most games, has remappable input, which means I need to have an image for every possible key that people might want to use for things. So I don't just use these images in this menu. They show up down the bottom there. You can see next to the box, show that you can open your inventory. And also they can be used in dialogue. So because they're used in dialogue, that presents an interesting issue. Like normally you could probably just get away with having an empty key graphic with a label on top that you set the label for that. But if you have it as in a rich text label, it has to be an image if you're going to do that. I use Inkscape to make my UI art, and these keyboard keys are no exception. The difference here is that I didn't actually make all these individually. I have a template that I run that generates most of them. So I made an add-on for that kind of thing, which is this generate keyboard sprites. And what that does is, so it grabs all of the characters that I want to make available as inputs, accounting for some special cases where the character showing on the key is different to what Godot treats it as the key code. It grabs that template, opens it up, and because SVG is just text, it's XML, it does a string replace looking for this exclamation mark, A exclamation mark, which is like, this is what the template looks like. So it looks inside the XML for this string here to swap out for the character per key. And then saves that again. But one problem we have there is Godot doesn't read in text objects from SVGs. So one thing Inkscape is great for is it can take that text and turn it into a path which is read in. So you can see here all of these actually have the character on them, but that's not text, that's a path within the SVG. So how we do that is Inkscape has a pretty good command line interface. You can do lots of stuff. I don't do any of this stuff really. I just use this one thing where you can export out as a converting text to paths, which is just here. So we export text to path and export overwrite back over the clone file, and the file name is like the one that we come in with the key. So what we end up with is all of these. Well, not all of them actually, some of them I did manually. Like the enter key, space, tab, a few of those. But yeah, all these ones in this list here are all generated automatically. Now I could probably tidy this up and make it run in a thread, because it does actually lock up Godot for like a minute, but how often do you need to regenerate these? So it just means if I change the basic template, then I just regenerate it and then it's done in a minute and I've got all of them again. And that's pretty much all there is for that. As always, if you have a question, then drop a comment below or join my Discord and we'll have a chat. Till next time, I'll see you there, or I'll see you here again soon. Bye.